was, hey girl, I got some country style ribs today, and we're gonna be using some of JB's rub on it, the Head Boy rub. And so far, I've tried this. I should have took some shots of that. I did some stewed cabbage on St. Patrick's Day with corned beef, and it came out real good in the stewed cabbage. It had a little bit of sweetness, some heat, some garlic, and I also put it on a baked potato. I put it on a pizza. The sweet heat blended really well with the pizza that I just made with it. It would be good on steamed vegetables, any damn thing. So let's get our little package. I got a small package. I'm gonna go smoke them on my free gas up, and with hickory wood for a while. Let me wrench them in the zinc, and then we'll put some rub on there and go outside with camera number two. So you definitely want to wrench these, because see, there's bones in here, and there'd be bone fragments on the meat when it's been cut like that with that bandsaw they use in that little butchery shop. Also got the last end of the Big Johnson over there, and we're gonna go smoke it too. We'll apply JB's rub heavily on these and on the Johnson. Now just don't grill with this. The bean is, we're gonna smoke this Johnson and rub shouldn't burn. What is a Johnson, huh? It's an outboard motor. You knew that. OMC Corporation. Cooperation. Yeah, that's the word. Yeah, rub all that rub on that. Yeah, that's the second side that I'm putting it on now, getting on the edges and the corners and all that. Barbecue that snowman. Ha!
It's spring done sprung, boy. See there, I got green grass. Yes, fig trees bloomed. So I went ahead and I bought some new vaporizer plates for the grill. And when I did a test run, grease dripping on these, it tends to stop up the little jets on the side, even though they cast iron. So it really needs these vaporizer plates. And they're going to help us, because now we can take them and turn two of them like so, upside down, and put wood on them. Put the grate on top, and we cook with wood. We could put charcoal on them if we wanted to also. But we just leave this burner lid on low. We got smoke, put the meat on the other side, and I'll be happy. Will you be happy, Cammy? Tough. Here we are on camera view number two, just for you, baby. Oh yeah. Just put them ribs over here for indirect heat on this side. And put that Big Johnson right in there. Lay it on there, buddy. Roll around in that rub some more. Our wood smoking. Close him down. And let him go. I even replaced the thermometer. It's a cheap one, but that's good enough for government work. Camera view number two just for you, huh? Cool word. Ah. Oh, yum. I mentioned that was hickory, huh? Okay.
So what is a country style rib? Is that something that's cut from a country style pig? It's America's finest creation. America's butchers. Nothing wrong with them, except a few around here. I done had some words with them. Basically, it's cut pork butt. Yeah, cut from the pork butt, which is not from the butt. It's actually from the shoulder. A ham is actually from the pork leg, the thigh section of the pork leg. Yeah, so these are ribs, pork ribs. Did y'all know there's 5 different types of ribs? Let's see if y'all can name them. So what kind of sides you gonna make, JB? Something easy. I don't feel like doing nothing. I had to slice them bananas the other day. I got some of these. It said 25% more free. That means Lanyap is some extra free. And it's pretty good. I've had this before. I don't think I showed it on video, but it's good. Cut up some real bacon, fry some real bacon, and throw it in there too. But it tastes pretty good like that. Fresh out the damn box and fresh out the damn can. I'm gonna have some Trappist black eyed peas and flavor with bacon slab, and this ain't no shit. This tastes good right in the can. I ain't getting paid for that. They don't send me shit free. I had to go buy it. It's good. If you can find it, try it. You'll see what I'm talking about. Look, tube milk. See? Test tube milk. Ha! Who writes my stuff? Nobody. I just drink a pop, think about something, and it jump out of my mouth. Food jump in my mouth. Words jump out my mouth. Sometimes the brain don't think about it first, and it may should, but we can edit that. See, that's what editing's all about. Now, one thing I've learned is that this is primarily a grill, and it does grilling very well. I'm going to go ahead and finish these off inside because I really don't think they're all the way done. We'll just put them in the oven and let them finish up on a bacon rack. Although I don't know, they may be totally done. It's a good question. We'll have to sample a piece. But we're going to shut this down and I'm going to let it clean itself up, being as it is hot. Just for the hell of it. Yeah, so far we've tried this rub, and it tastes better with the new label on it too. Just about everything. Only thing I hadn't tried it on was ham. Like a whole ham. Not a honey glazed ham or anything like that, just a plain picnic roast. I know it'd be great on that. Or even a already smoked ham. Put some on there and go stick it on the grill. And let it warm up at 300 or under. Give it a nice, nice coating on the outside. Nice glaze with that. You can make a glaze with this, as a matter of fact, just by adding some instant water, or diet water, just water, boy. Great on brisket, ribs, poke chops. You can sprinkle it on bananas and eat them like that. Apples, fresh, just dump it on there, eat, yum. Great, great product. Thanks, JB, for making that. Oh, click right here, and you can, on that link there. take you to where you buy it. Cool, huh?
Yeah, I even sprinkle some on some bacon and it come out good. Right at the end of cooking it. It was great. And these came out fine. Loved them. I ate all of them, as a matter of fact. JP didn't get none, not even a boner. Yeah, that yellow stuff was okay. It wasn't as good as the mashed potatoes that they sell. A boy, a girl, a bye.